198, 199, 200, brilliant.
Done.
Hi everyone, welcome to my Gav's World vlog. I'm pretty new to this vlogging game. Right, so I'm doing a marathon this year, the London Marathon. It's in April 2016, and quite frankly, I have not even trained one bit for it. I have literally not even started doing any marathon training whatsoever. Right now, I'm eating cake in between press-ups. Mint cake as well. I've also been scoffing pizza, which is a really terrible idea to do. There's a Domino's right down the road from where I live. I eat out far too much. It's a consequence of like working out and about till quite late a lot. You end up eating out too much. So, no more eating out for me. That mint cake's really nice. The reason I'm doing the marathon is because I got asked by the Cystic Fibrosis Trust, who are a wonderful charity who help to prolong the lives of people who suffer from cystic fibrosis. They asked me to get involved with the marathon back end of 2015, and I said yes. So I really appreciate them asking me. And essentially, cystic fibrosis, if you don't know what it is a genetic condition which affects people's lungs and digestive systems with sticky mucus, and it's not the nicest of conditions at all. But I can't back out now, and I need to get myself active and properly training. Running, oh my word, right. So instead of just doing boring runs, you know, every now and again, every, I don't know, every 3 days or something, I don't know, 10 miles to start with, maybe up to 12, then keep going up and up, and then maybe bring it down a bit, then go up again. That's boring. Fair enough, I'll have to do a bit of running to get my body used to it. I'm gonna do a few cool, quirky, and crazy challenges and fitness regimes to get myself into the spirit of the marathon. I'm gonna be doing some Pilates, I'm gonna be doing some high intensity stuff, gonna be doing some boxing training, all those kind of things. Because right now I'm letting myself go big time. I would show you the layers under here, but yeah, sort of. I'll show you a bit there. There we go. Oh, by the way, hope you like the slippers. Boom, boom, boom. I'm not actually doing any training today. I'm kind of sort of like led you on a little bit. I need to get my running trainers sorted. And you need to do that with a sort of proper analysis, gait analysis they call it. I've come to Run and Become, which is a well-known shop in central London. Here it is now. So let's go and get gait analysed. And is it important to get the right shoes? Because I mean, my ones right now, they're just bog standard trainers.
When sometimes people think, oh, it's not worth it, I do just a couple of miles a week, that's fine. But actually, if you don't get the right running shoes, and that's what we see here quite often, if customer comes without being fitted properly before, then they can get some problems like niggles or pain, injuries even.
What does the gait analysis actually do then? What do you find out from it?
With gait analysis, we're finding how people run, what they need in case, if they are neutral runners, then they need neutral shoes. If they overpronate, meaning if their knees are rolling in or arches are going in, then yeah, they need some support.
Yeah, let's get going on it then. Cool, I'm having a gait analysis then. Brilliant. Polka dot green and whites. I think they're Pharrell designed actually. They're quite, so these are the neutral running shoes. Yeah. The beauties of vlogging,
yes.
Not tying laces.
So if
they're actually pretty stylish.
Yeah, you like that one?
Yeah, they're not bad.
And I can see actually your arches and your ankles when you run.
Like that?
Yeah. Just slowly, just
okay,
a slow jog,
slowly.
Yeah?
All right.
Okay.
Here we go. Watch me trip up.
Okay.
I always think that I run really stupidly.
No,
I always
no.
think I run really stupidly. It's like I kind of waddle.
Keep your feet hip width apart and bend your knees down towards me. So just the knees, and try to keep your feet on the floor.
Right, keep feet on the floor.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and up.
Yeah.
And you're actually putting the same amount of pressure on your feet as while you're running. So it shows me in detail what's happening when you run outside.
Okay, cool.
Your arches are quite flat, especially the
yeah.
right one. Basically, I would recommend you shoes with support
yeah.
for overpronation
yeah.
and mainly the arch support. And now we need to test actually what kind of model will work for you the best. So
okay.
we need to try a few different options. Basically, what we say, the right running shoes should feel like slippers.
Okay,
so
I like the sound of that.
Yeah. The right running technique or posture is to have an alignment in your legs. So that legs should be aligned like this. If there is any, you know, disbalance, like for example arches going in like that or knee is going in like that, that's, we call it overpronation. You should give them support, mm-hmm. the arch, and then when you have support here, like in this shoe for example, then it will hold you nicely, it will prevent you from rolling in, it will keep your foot stable.
You're right to do my laces again. I feel like I'm in primary school.
Any kind of problems, discomfort, lumps or bumps in the shoe, just let me know, because that's not what you want. Sometimes people think, oh, well, they will be alright, I need to get used to them. No, we say they should feel straight, comfortable straight away.
Self-conscious about running.
Okay. How does it feel?
Yeah, it feels good. It feels good. I think I feel very bouncy, which is good. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but your right foot was slightly going in.
Yeah.
So I just want to try some other models.
I really like these shoes, so you don't think they'd work for me though?
Yeah, because these are neutral shoes, so they would be for someone who has a neutral gait.
Yeah.
But in your case, as your arches are rolling in, they would not be stable for you and you would be, you know...
Oh, right. So around. I'd be all over the place. Yeah. So these are
A6 shoes.
Yep.
And they have got blocks of gel as a cushioning.
Oh, gel ones, yeah.
Yeah, they're quite popular. Yeah.
Yeah. Have you ever had black shoes as well, running shoes before?
Oh, really?
I've always had like really crazy colours, for example.
Oh, yeah.
These are the best ones, I think. I'm not just saying that because they look cool, but they genuinely are, they're all the best ones. It's like the most support, most cushioning around my heels, my sort of instep as well.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, they feel good. So we are trying on all sorts here, aren't we? Yeah, I think it's important to get the right pair, isn't it? So 7 we've tried on so far now. So I've decided to go for these ones here, A6s. That's the same brand, the same type, but just different colour. But I'm going to go for these ones, I think. Black and yellow, like a bumblebee running the marathon. Really happy with this choice. They felt really comfortable. Really good on the feet, really good on the soles. What do you think? Good choice?
Yes, I think these are good, nice. They will give you good cushioning and also the support. So
there we are. Yeah. They look good as well, don't they? Look at
that. Can be your first marathon shoes.
I know.
Happy ones.
Thank you very much indeed. Yeah.
They are the A6 GT 2000s. Nice gel sole, black and yellow. I like the look of them. They feel good as well.
It's going to be a really tough one. This is. I'm really not looking forward to it. I just think. Well, I'm looking forward to it, obviously, it's an amazing cause, and the one thing I really don't want to happen in this marathon is to start it and then to pull up. You start the marathon, you get going, and then 4 miles in, you realise you haven't done any training, and then you have to pull up, and that's my worst nightmare, so I need to get myself properly fit again. There we are, that's the first part of the marathon journey sort of done. You need to get a good pair of shoes, got them, tick. And do feel free to subscribe and like and... comment as well in the box below, and like's down there as well, isn't it? And then subscribe somewhere around there. Yeah, I'll work it out eventually. Hit like, write a comment, write abuse if you want to write abuse. Tell me my trainers are rubbish. Let me know if you want me to try out any fitness ideas or stuff that you think might be funny. And I look forward to hearing from you and reading them. And subscribe as well. It's all in these boxes here. So yeah, do it. Click stuff. Have a watch some of the videos as well. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.
You are looking green. Right, so there's one finishing touch. It's gonna be nippy outside anyway, cold, so put that on.
Put a bit of this on.
Still looking green.
Yep.
And you need to do something about the air cut. So let's go.
Let's go.
So Joey, you're famous for having